I really feel like I am helping do something for this country.
When you get down to it, it's very, very simple. This is all about us.
Hi, I'm Brian Bradshaw. I'm here with Boone Pickens. This is part of an ongoing series of educational energy videos. Boone, today I thought we would talk a little bit about this mass hysteria over electric vehicles. They have been everywhere in the news, Tesla specifically. It's been everywhere in the news. It got a very high rating from Consumer Reports. Can you just kind of speak to, is the age of the electric vehicle upon us? Is it here now?
Yes, it's here, but it's here at what price? And you're looking at a vehicle now that's about $80,000, and you get about 200 or 300 miles range out of it. I sound like I'm against electric vehicle. I'm not. I'm for anything American. That's fine. But know this, where my focus has been is on heavy-duty trucks. I'm on heavy-duty trucks, locomotives, and ships, big users of fuel. And the battery will not move an 18-wheeler. So that's out, and my fuel stands alone with diesel. Natural gas and diesel are the two fuels to use for heavy-duty. And the natural gas is 30% cleaner than diesel and half the price of diesel. So the natural gas will be used is what's going to happen. But the electric car, it does have a place, no question. And it's people are going to pay a big price, so not everybody is in range of the electric car. Now, I know in 3 or 4 years they tell you it's going to be down to $40,000. And that's good. All of that's fine. I don't want anybody to have the idea I'm opposed to electric vehicles or anything else. But you have to know the electricity has to come from somewhere to power the car. So where does it come from? I remember years ago in California, they would talk about electric car, and I said, well, but the electricity comes from somewhere. Where does it come from? And most people would look at the wall socket. And that's where it comes from. Where does the water come from? It comes from the faucet. Turn it on, you get water. Plug in, you get electricity. Well, electricity comes from somewhere, and power generation comes over 50%. Well, it's down a little under 50% now. Is coal is where your power comes from. Natural gas is 20 now above 25%. 20% is nuclear, and the rest of it is wind, solar, and hydro. So it's right now a great amount of your power comes from fossil fuels, coal and natural gas. So those are there, and they will be there for years and years to come. We need to understand the resources in America, understand the resources, and then properly deploy those resources is what we have to do. And so the electric car, yes, natural gas, heavy duty is the way to go.
Boone, thank you very much for your time. As always, feel free to post questions or comments underneath the video. Thank you.